In our last video, we took you behind the scenes of a performance day in the life of a 30-week pregnant ballerina, aka me. Today, we'll share with you the incredible support team my husband and I have during this most exciting phase of our lives. Don't forget to like and subscribe.
10, 9, 8, 7.
10 more weeks?
Yeah.
Oh my God. 10 more weeks.
10 more weeks in 2 days.
That's crazy.
You just
My heart is pounding, you know?
So today, can you tell what's going to happen today?
We have 2 doulas. We never talk about it, I think.
No, right? I think it's the first time we talk about that.
And you know what's interesting about it? Is because Rupa, which is one of the doulas, is actually a follower in Instagram and Facebook. And when I had the miscarriage, she wrote me a beautiful message. And then she also told me she's a doula. And whenever I was going to be pregnant again, because she was sure I was going to be pregnant again,
yeah,
and I want to use her service, she would love to help us out.
Yeah.
And I screenshot the message.
You saved.
Because I'm like, you know, she's right. I will gonna get pregnant again and I'm gonna meet her.
Yeah.
And whenever I got pregnant again, one of the first thing I did was like,
what is this message? Where did I screenshot
it? You were looking for it like desperate.
I saved on my notes.
Mm-hmm.
And then I found her again. And she's gonna be one of our doulas. She has a team of doulas. She's a former nurse. And we met them already, Rupa and Radisha. And today...
they're coming to meet us here at our place. Well, first of all, I wanna say that how important this is for Anna and I. You know, I think it's important for all of first-time parents or even for parents that already have kids. But for Anna and I, we were a little bit worried that we don't have her family here with us. My mom is here, but she's helping taking care of my nephew, and so...
and also, like, this thing of being English being our second language, mm-hmm, and we were... I was maybe overthinking a little bit, like, when I am in labor and we are at the doctor...
and we don't understand all the terms,
and
yeah.
And they say things to us, and we would just say yes for everything, because, you know...
and I
knowing
think that's,
us, we would just be a little...
we went to visit my sister when she had her baby, like a couple months ago. And we were in the room, and it's a little bit chaotic.
Yeah, for it's them, like, it's supernatural. It's just another labor.
Right.
But for us, first timers...
we were there, like, just checking everything. We're like, whoa, Junior, you need to know this. You need to know that. And I'm like, whoa.
Because, like, we are in a situation where we're already so vulnerable.
Vulnerable, yeah, for sure.
And so... the doulas, they really advocate for us. Like, we have those meetings before the labor, and then we're playing my labor, if I wanna the epidural or not, and what happens if we need a C-section, what happens this. She will basically translate for us with all her patience, whatever
and love
we need
and care.
To, and love and
care. And the first thing is,
and
like...
she will help, sorry, Dave.
Go ahead.
But she will help me with the breathing,
right,
and with the massage.
Everything that you need
whenever
to know.
Whatever kind of pain I have, she will be on both of our sides. They will be, because it's 2 of them.
Yeah, it's fun because I spoke to your mother when we went to Brazil this year, and she said that she was kind of like depressed in the beginning of her first child because she had no help. She had nobody to help her. You know, like, she had no guidance. She didn't know what to do. She was like discovering by doing it. And I know a lot of people saying that, oh, you discover by doing it. Of course, we want to discover things by ourselves, but it's very good to have a guidance, you know, like it's... I was explaining to my mom about the doula, and she's like, oh, yeah, that's kind of interesting. Because it's not a normal thing in Brazil. Maybe it is these days.
It's now, yes. It was
but back
common.
Then, nobody had that.
I don't think it was common anywhere. It's kind of a new thing.
Right.
Or at least for me, that's just learning about those things.
Once we first went to meet them, we sat at a coffee shop, and then they were kind of like, we have no questions yet, but they were just telling us everything that they were supposed to do with us throughout the whole pregnancy. And I could see Anna's face. She was like, from this to like...
I feel like they are that friend or that parent that knows everything and you can really rely on them. They text me back and forth. I text them questions a lot, like any time of the day I can text them or call them. But today we're gonna meet with them also, and they are bringing a doctor. She is a pelvic floor therapist. And I suppose she does some pelvic rounds.
Like round.
I don't know what that means yet, but it sounds fun. and also they're bringing a wellness coach.
That's really?
Yeah.
Wow.
A wellness coach. A wellness?
A wellness
coach.
Right.
Who is doing a guided meditation with the both of us.
A guided meditation?
Yeah. Because that's another thing that they can do. They can do this guided meditation to us, and then the day of, we can kind of put ourselves in that zone.
In that state.
In that
state. I like that. It's very important. They're very important.
So yeah, it's going to be for both of us, baby.
You're about to knock in like what? All right.
Hello.
Hi there. Hi guys, come in please.
It doesn't bark much. How are you?
Good.
How are you?
Good to see you.
How are you doing?
Enrique.
Thank
you. I don't know if you know.
No, we didn't.
It's Enrique. Yeah. My
little name. There is something in what you're telling us as far as divine intervention, because babies can communicate.
Oh, I
in utero.
That was him. It was him telling us.
Yeah.
It wasn't in my thought at all. And then
it's
I had
also
this
a connection that you have. You know, moms have a strong connection with their babies. Even dads do. If they're involved, they with the pregnancy and stuff. So there, when you have that bond and connection, there is telepathy going on.
Yeah.
So whatever you think, whatever you talk, everything is going inside.
Yeah.
And then the baby communicates in different ways.
Yeah.
I mean, of course, and not we. We know that not all communication is verbal.
Yeah.
Only, you know, 10% or 15% is verbal. Mm-hmm. The rest is all either connection or your environment or your body language. So how will a baby communicate?
And it's so funny because Junior said he has my attitude. The way I explained to him how the drink was, like, oh my God, he sounds just like you.
And this connection that you two have is also passing down. Mm-hmm. So when parents are connected like that, you won't see a lot of people with that kind of connection, where they understand each other, they understand each other's needs. So the baby also, you pass that down inside.
Mm-hmm.
And when they're hearing everything and they're feeling everything. So he probably feels, you know what? These two have a voice. I have a voice too.
Oh yeah, he does.
I'm gonna say what I want.
This is gonna be nice. I can't wait to meet him.
Yeah.
Healthcare. We didn't have midwife, we didn't have all those things.
Right.
So the doulas were there to support and get Black women to have healthy babies.
Yeah.
What's happened is it's now shifted. Social media, right? Everybody, doula, it sounds great. We don't, every time we talk to someone, they don't really, they're like, oh, I just saw it on social media. So they don't really understand what we do and what we provide and what level of service we're offering and why we are important.
Right.
It's just, it sounds good.
Cool.
Oh, I want it. My friend had
a became a thing.
It's the cool thing
to do then. So the essence is lost.
It's
when
lost.
It became a fad.
Exactly.
Then it becomes a fad. Yeah. So
and that's where we like. It's like it's not just we're not trending, right? This is something we've wanted to do for a long time. We couldn't do because of scheduling and just where we were in life. Rupa got into it. Then it's like it has to be the right time. If you're really doing it for what it's supposed to be to have impact.
Mm-hmm.
Then it isn't a trend.
So
right?
You're saying it was a culture thing.
It's cultural. It was a cultural
in
thing in Africa.
Yeah.
Yep.
And they work with a lot less over there.
Yeah.
The doulas there are on their feet, sometimes with long births, 24, 48 hours.
Mm-hmm.
They're working with no tools.
Yep.
But over there, it's real community work. We brought everybody on our team is certified and experienced. Everyone is doing their individual thing as well.
Mm-hmm.
But at the end of the day, we're all here to help women.
It's a support group.
It's a
support
group.
That's what it is. Because it's a team of people. I mean, of course, the main two, but the others, it's a team of people who provide that support that is needed at that moment.
So it's about healthy mother, healthy baby. That is what the end result is.
That I can't do that.
We're gonna start here. Then you can all the way feel a good stretch. Do you feel opening in the chest?
Mm-hmm.
You can hold it for 30 seconds.
Essentially what this is doing is our spine back here is getting tight. Usually our muscles in the back get tight. These muscles in the abdominal wall get weak as, you know, we're changing. Our body's changing to make room for the baby. So kind of doing this helps open up the chest and get some movement going into your person.
So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna place my hands on your shoulders. And have you ever had Reiki before?
No.
Okay, so it's just it's energy healing. So I am going to tap into energy and pass it into you. Right? So both of you, you are connecting with your baby. So this is a connection meditation. And this is specially just for the two of you. Okay. So we start by relaxing into our seat.
How are you doing right today?
We could see the connection between you. When she was working with you, you could just see that the energy bond is just going between you two. And it's nice because your baby got the best of it today. He really did.
We so appreciate it. It's very important for the both of us, right? Yeah. Like, you don't know the importance until you do it.
You both have made this pregnancy into something so positive because we watch your reels too. We do. And we see it. Yeah. So kudos to you.
Yeah. Well, we can only say thank you to all of you. We are very lucky to have such special people in our lives, right? Like, I don't know what we did to deserve this, but like you guys were saying earlier, it's like good people attract good people. Yes. And I want to believe that we are good people. But I mean, he's the luckiest one. We are done with our meeting.
They just left. Sorry, babe.
Go ahead. She's tired. She exercised so much. They just left now. But I'm going to talk about what I thought. What I can tell from what just happened is that I wasn't expecting that. Mm. You know what I mean? Like, I was excited to see them. I was excited to learn a little more. It's like the unknown until the whole thing happened. I feel like it was a great way for us to create that bond, create that environment that will give us the state that will put us in the state we need to in order to make things easier now from now on, even though I feel like you've been like so, you know, so good about everything. You've been so positive. The Reiki was really good. Yeah. The meditation was very good. I like to see you doing the exercise, things that you don't do usually, even though you're a dancer, it's like, it's a different way of stretching and everything.
Yeah, because it's not a exercise. It's like a minimal thing.
Adjustment, right?
Minimal adjustment, very internal things, mm-hmm. Not like really exercise. I thought that would be like, I don't know, doing some floor work. You know, it's really, really minimal, really, really.
It's crazy how
more focused.
The smallest things are the most meaningful things.
Yeah.
Like, sometimes you don't need too much. You don't need big things to make you happy, to make you good or feel good. I feel like the whole environment, the whole team, they were so ready to put us in the place where we're like, whoa, yeah, what we're going through now is very special, and we don't want to miss this later. I want to be like, oh, we're not 100% in it, and they just made us feel like we are special by becoming parents. We are special that we care about our baby, and we are doing the whole thing in order for you to feel good, because you're the one that, you're the oven.
Yeah.
Right?
Everything I feel, he feels.
It's very important, very important. It's a great way of experience that, and also learning a little bit more about what the doulas can do, what the, not only doulas, but like the supportive team, like a supportive group of people. So in any case in life, if you have a good support system, you're good to go. You're good to do your own thing. And I feel like we are covered, not only with them, but also with you guys. For the last post, you guys have been amazing with all the amazing messages, the gifts, with the words and the everything
the
that
love.
We've been receiving. The love. Yeah, we've been receiving so much love, and we are so happy about it, and we are so lucky to have you guys here. So lucky to have all this amazing group of amazing people and nice and good people around us. So it was a great experience.
Yeah.
So with that, we want to ask you guys, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, please do so. Like this video. Share with your friends and family. We'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.
See you next time.
Bye.